Hey, you hear me say? You better get out on your knees,
thank you. Well, this is the center of rural music. And think about that tradition is that it's evergreen and it keeps replenishing itself. So we're going to bring up an artist now who's just getting started, his first record coming out. Young man by the name of Lance Miller, and he's going to be backed up by another newcomer named Jimmy Stewart.
Jimmy Stewart on dobro here with me today. I heard Merle Haggard do this Tammy Wynette's funeral years ago, and I thought it was appropriate then. Hopefully it is today.
Almost felt you touching me just now.
Transpired. And so our next performer, she's soldiering on. She had a song picked out that she was going to do that she does regularly and is well rehearsed. But we said we're changing what we're doing. We're going to take another tack. We're going to go more gentle and more reverent. And I happen to know this song that she's written recently. I know the song, and she's never performed it live. And she told me that she's pretty nervous about this, but she's going to be a real soldier and perform this song for the first time live in front of an audience. The brave Shelley Rowe.
Thanks, Warren. Thanks, Wyatt. What would I do without you? Thanks, Warren. Y'all doing okay today? I know how we're doing today. I'll down a little bit, can point it down a little bit. As Robbie told you, I've never played this song before. That's what it means. And to go you one better than that, never having played this song, I'm new to guitar. So there's nothing like coming out on the rhyming stage. A little bit more on the guitar thing, Mark. I had a song called Bumper of My SUV I was fully prepared to do. But because of today, Robbie called me many hours ago and said, "How you doing, pal?" I said, "I'm hurt. I'm wounded. I'm sad. I've been crying." He said, "Come on down here and bring that guitar and sing that song about pain, because that's what we're doing today. That's what we're feeling." So I humbly offer this to you. Walking this tightrope here, easy does it, take it slow. I know the peril inside that awaits me there below. I've been trying hard lately to focus on the goodness around. But if I fall, if I slip and fall, baby, there's no avoiding crashing to the ground. So I pray, oh God, I pray. Don't look down, don't give a light. Don't look down, you're gonna be alright. Sometimes it consumes me. How did it all go so bad? Sometimes everything reminds me. I stare a couple
kids. Vince Gill, come on, bro. Guess where I was when Rodney called. What's that? It is. I'd find a place to play golf on Monday, honey. Well, Rodney called about an hour ago and said, what are you doing? I said, well, I'm on the 12th hole right now. I'm okay. And he said, well, can you get down here right away? I said, sure. So I played my way in. I was as far away from the clubhouse as I could be. And played my way back in and came down. I didn't know it was a dressing affair, so I'm sorry. But he said that we were going to have a day of healing for the tragedy that happened in Virginia. And I said, I'll be there in a heartbeat. I just came flying down here as fast as I could get here. So excuse my appearance, but my heart is in the right place. And this is a song about healing. And it's going to take a lot of healing for a lot of people. And that's what this song is about.
Your sweet voice, don't
Stage crew said, can you fill a minute? Absolutely.
That's my job in life, to be the third wheel, the wheel, a minute filler. If I didn't come here for John Edwards, I'd never get to the stage in the Ryman. Good afternoon, my fellow Tennesseans. I'm very glad to be here this afternoon, and I thought, well, if the brother I never wanted, Vince, can come out in badger shorts having played golf, I can come no makeup, unbrushed hair, and stinky armpits. I was out in Leapers Fork working this afternoon and very delighted to come in to hear what the great and good John Edwards has to say, because I still believe in this process. Mother Church of American Music, I'm here today with an open mind to have no contempt prior to investigation, so I can learn how to be a part of the solution, because we do live in very troubled times, as the tragedy in Virginia makes so vividly clear, and my heartfelt condolences go out to those who were immediately affected, but also to all of us, because we are tangentially affected. And we live in a society that is so difficult and so troubled. But as I said, I do still continue to believe that there is a process at work within our republic that can manifest the American dream. And I believe that each individual has not just the opportunity, but the responsibility to participate in that process. And it's not a burden, it's a gift. We are told that we can make manifest the glory of God that is within each of us, that we can fulfill our birthright to have enough to eat, to have clean water to drink, to be in charge of our reproductive health, to decide if and when how many children we can bring into this world safely, so that we can want it and love and provide for. And we're also given the promise that we can use our talents, that those things that are unique to each of us as individuals will be given the opportunity to help better humankind. And so I'm very interested in what happens in this next election. I like the bumper sticker that says, hey, is it 2008 yet? Anybody see that one? I like the fucking woman that said to myself, is it 2008 yet? You know, and a lot of people have already slotted me in with some of the other people who are seeking the nomination from my party. And I don't really know yet, but I am committed to learning, to listening, and to maintaining that faith that I have the opportunity to be a part of the solutions. I just came home from 3 weeks in India, and it was an absolutely life-changing, devastating trip. That country is faced with challenges that were they're almost unspeakable, and they appear insurmountable. Just the numbers themselves are tremendous. 1.2 billion people, 800 million of whom live in poverty. Half of those, abject poverty. We're talking a dollar a day. It's really staggering. But I know as a first world citizen, and as an American citizen, I can do my part abroad and at home. So thank you, my fellow Tennesseans. I salute you for coming out today. And thanks so much, Mr. Edwards, for reaching out to me. I really appreciate it. And hey, I got to talk at the Ryman.
Many times since, and we have lots of friends here. This day began very different than it is at this moment. I woke up in South Carolina planning to talk about what we need to do about rural America, how we save rural America, issues near and dear to my own heart. Some of the things Ashley talked about, having the American dream alive and well for all of us, which is a huge part of why I'm running for president. But my belief is now, this moment is, I came here planning to talk about politics, what we need to do for America, what we need to do here at home, what we need to do around the world. But this tragedy that took place at Virginia Tech earlier today changed all that. I don't believe this is the right time, speaking for myself, for politics. I think it's a time for us to unite, for us to show our love, support, and community for all those families who've been devastated in Virginia. Unfortunately, Elizabeth and I understand, as a lot of you know, in a very personal way, what it's like to be the parents who have lost their children. At Virginia Tech, their precious children. And they need their Lord and they need you. I can tell you that from personal experience. They need to feel you out there. They need to know that you're there for them. You know, we've had, like probably many of you, maybe most of you, we've had too many days that changed from the time you woke up until later in the day. Elizabeth and I have had one just in the last few weeks. But I can tell you from personal experience that having people like you, people like these extraordinary musicians who played their hearts out here this afternoon, who exposed themselves and their souls to their music, having them and you there, and understanding that all of us, whatever our politics, are part of a national community, and being there for each other, and understanding that what we do together says something about who we are, what we are as a nation. And so we want today, we change this event, I guess that's obvious now, to not be a political event, but to, as Vince said, an event of healing. Mostly we want the people in Virginia who have been struck by this tragedy, the families, to feel us, to feel our love and our support for them, because I, like most of you, know from personal experience how important it is. I was speaking to Elizabeth on the way here this afternoon, and I said, you know, what should I say? Do you have a message? I'm very proud of Elizabeth. You know, she's a woman of great clarity and courage, and especially at times when all of us are challenged, and she said, well, why don't you share with them the hymn that we love to sing, and that have been sung to us many times when we've been faced with challenges. And unfortunately for me, I don't have it in my head. Age. But I do want to share it with you. It's, in our end is our beginning, in our time, infinity, in our doubt, there is believing, in our life, eternity, in our death, the resurrection, at the last, a victory, unrevealed until it's seen, something God alone can see. Let's pray. Lord, our precious Lord, please lift up and hold the families who are struggling and suffering with incredible pain and tragedy today. Hold their children in your arms. Let them know that they're in a good place. Let these families feel all of us, our love, our support, and our affection for them. And let them know that we, and all of our national community, will be there for them today. We will be there for them tomorrow. And we will always be there for them. In Christ's name. Amen.
They have to sing. Now's your time to come out.
'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear.
Very much.